All right, so it looks like Adobe's up to it yet again, fixing things that weren't broken in the first place. Today, what we're going to look at is speed ramping in the newest version of Adobe 2024. Now, this is Adobe Premiere 2024, and they've changed how you access speed ramping. This can be very frustrating. Luckily, you can still get it pretty easy. Let me show you how to do it. Okay, so here I am in Adobe Premiere, and as you can see, I've got my timelines here in the sequence, and this is really where the big change goes. If you look at the beginning of the clip, there used to be a little icon that Premiere had that you could right-click, and if you right-clicked on it, it would give you options for opacity, speed ramping, things like that. As you can see, this icon is no longer here. Luckily, it's still something that's very, very easy to find. What you need to do now is just right-click on your timeline. Now, it doesn't matter. You don't have to do it at the beginning. You can literally do it anywhere in there. So if you right-click anywhere on there, you will see something down here at the bottom that says Show Clip Keyframes. And here is where you're going to get the motion opacity and time remapping that you used to get there. Now, once again, just click speed and boom, and now the timeline will come up and it's ready for speed ramping. And just for those of you that aren't aware of how speed ramping works, I have a clip here. What you can basically do is you can set a time. If you're on a Mac, if you hold on a command, you can click on that. It'll give you a little cross beam, maybe have the motion come up a little further. You can go a little bit like this. Maybe you want to go there. You can click on that. That'll give you 2 points, and then you can just basically pull up or pull down and get the different speeds. So I can go down to 1%, or I can bring this all the way up. And you know, let's just say I wanna bring that transition like to really fast, say like 4,000, 5,000%. Well, now what I can do is I can do that and bring that in, and now it'll, boom, pop right there and give me that classic time remapping they want. Then you can also, if you wanna do a little more of a bezier curve, you can start to pull out these handles here and start to basically, that'll let you ease in or ease out of your ramp a little bit. So as you can see, the time remapping function is just there. They just removed how we've typically gotten to it, and it's something I thought you might want to know. Anyway, I hope that's helpful. Love to hear what you have to say with this. Let me know what's in the comments, and I'll talk to you soon.